Hi, and welcome to another episode of Hot Takes with me, the Silver Fox, and obviously I'm not going to be doing full long videos today until we have a full long video slot. Pointless doing something long with a fast moving story like this. Now, there are rumours, and it's only that speculation, it's mentioned in two outlets, that there will be, potentially at least, a press conference at between 10 and 10:30 this morning, maybe. He did have one booked on Friday for 9:30 a.m. and that never happened. He cancelled out at the last minute, so you never know. But it is looking increasingly likely that he will step down today, and it's likely to be this morning. There's also, and I don't know again how true this is, but it has been mentioned by two different people that there is, what do you call them, a pantechnicon, a removals van, on its way, hastening all the way up to Butte House. Again, this might just be wishful thinking or humorous speculation. There's no guarantee on it either one. That's the problem. There's no news, and so everything becomes speculative. But we do know some things. Now, we know that it is likely for John Swinney to take over as pro tem leader. That's almost there. It's noting, and weird, of course, that the Deputy First Minister, Shona Robertson, is not taking over as First Minister. She must be sitting at home thinking, hang on a minute, I'm the Deputy First Minister. If he steps down, I've got to be stepping into the role temporarily. But, of course, no one in their right mind would let Shona Robertson anywhere near the power. No way, she's bad enough. You can't let a complete retard take that seat. Hamza's bad, but at least he's, you know, capable of communication and can read, just. But Shona, not a chance. And I think that will upset her deeply. And I think that this will be a rejection for her personally. She may take it very hard. She may resign as well. Hang on a minute, why am I? I don't want to be Deputy First Minister if when it becomes my turn they don't want me. Who knows with that? But Swinney taking over as the pro tem, sort of temporary leader, not a good look, really, considering the problems that he's likely to have and being so closely aligned with the former regime. So who else on a pro tem basis? I think, ironically, if you put Neil Gray in as a pro tem leader, it would be better. But of course, he's desperate for the job. He wants the job. We all know Beryl wants the job. Mary McCallum is sort of thinking of tipping her hat in. Spinning Jenny Gilruth wants it. There's possibly a few outsiders. Swinney, I think, would love to have an opportunity, but he must be nowhere near it. And of course, dear sweet Kate. I don't think it's going to get to the point where there will be, increasingly like this, that there'll be a straight handover. I think there's going to be a contest. And the great thing about a contest is it takes 6 to 8 weeks to run. And so they don't have a First Minister in that time, which means it has to be a Holyrood election. You could have a Holyrood election before a general election, and it's not out of the question of a July general election. And so you could have the SNP wiped out twice in a matter of, 6-8 weeks. I can hear the champagne corks already. Anyway, it's all up in the air. We'll keep the news reports coming as quickly as we can, as soon as anything breaks. Thank you very much for watching. We'll move on. Bye.